And thank you, Mr. Yas, for giving an insightful session. In fact, he's touched upon many of the things that I would be also covering in the presentation. So I represent Yash Compostables Limited. And what we really do is we... we design and come up with compostable packaging solutions for the market, which is also one of the topics of today, sustainability and the environment, which everyone has been talking about. So it is really also necessary to see and be very mindful of how much packaging is actually required for the package, for the product. So if you look at the graph, what happens is, while we are designing our packaging, it is also very important to be environmentally conscious of the entire manufacturing process and also the final product that we make. So when we go towards over packaging, according to the marketing trends, there are like package in a package in a package. And when you do over packing, so that also has a very negative environmental impact. And also when there is under packing done, then also there is a negative environmental impact, because then what happens is when you go towards more thinning of the material or really going under packing, so what happens is the quality reduces, and then the wastage that is incurred, that also increases, and that hence has a negative environmental impact. So what is really required is to have an optimum packing design which serves the functional for which the packaging is being designed and serves the product to the end customer. Now what happened with us was that, so our parent company is Yash Papers, which is based out of Faizabad, and for 37 years it has been making wrapping papers. So most of the soaps that you guys use in India, they are wrapped in our paper. Then McDonald's, Cafe Coffee Day, and various other brands are using our paper in their packaging. So although we were making compostable paper, now before I say more about it, there is a difference between biodegradable and compostable. Biodegradable, at the end life cycle, degrades into very small particles but does not disappear completely, whereas compostable solutions are those which degrades and then finally return to the soil. Now within compostable also, there are two types. There are industrially compostable and it is backyard compostable. Now unfortunately in India, we do not have industrial composters. So for example, solutions like the PLA, which is the polylactic acid, does not really solve the purpose, because that is also going to be there. And because it is industrially compostable and we do not have industrial composters in India yet. So the solutions that we were looking at were really backyard compostable. Now as I was saying that, in our company, we were making compostable paper, but then we realized that when it reaches to the end consumer, it is ultimately packaged between two layers of plastic. So it is as harmful as a normal plastic would be. So then it really dawned on us, and then our founder, Mr. Ved Krishna, he really started his quest towards looking at solutions which are backyard compostable. And then the paper that we were making with, one of the materials that we were using was sugarcane pulp, which is also called the bagasse. And what happens in bagasse is that when farmers harvest sugarcanes and they, that is gone to the sugar mills, wherein juice is extracted and sugar is made, the waste that is left, that is sugarcane pulp, which is bagasse, which we source and make paper out of that. So when we studied more about bagasse, it has magical properties almost. When under heat and pressure, it gets a magical charge and can be made into a really, really hard product. So you can achieve the tensile strength that we were looking for. So thus, through the processing of sugarcane, so sugarcane goes into waste, and then the waste is treated to make a valuable pulp, which we then produce further to make the compostable paper plates and bowls, the entire tableware range that we ultimately made. So then what really happened was that, because of his affinity towards nature, when he was working towards these solutions, there were really two directions in which the effort was being made. One was towards the flexible packaging, which everyone has also addressed. Now, flexible packaging, what happens is there are layers and layers and layers of plastic, which is highly engineered, but if we look at the end life cycle, then even rag pickers do not pick it, and it is very difficult to recycle them. And it takes 10,000 years or more for them to even start degrading. So then what really happens towards these flexible packaging? And that's why we are also working towards that along with an American university, and we are looking at nature again for examples. So when talking about packaging, the most beautiful examples that are present amongst us is by nature. So if you look at a banana, the packaging itself, by the color, the texture, it really tells you what the product will be inside. And no two packages look similar. So a packaging of a banana is very different from a packaging of a pomegranate. Now, if you look at the pomegranate, very delicate seeds. So there is an outer packaging, and then when you peel that off, there is very delicate structure which is present inside, which protects these delicate seeds and thus give us the unpacking experience that we have. So when we started looking at nature, we drew examples and inspirations from nature and then ventured into this field called biomimicry, in which we take inspiration from nature and thus re-look at the packaging materials completely. And one of the materials that we are working with is mycelium, which is made out of mushroom. How mushrooms multiply on their own, and then a material is made out of that, which is mycelium, and we are working towards that. So very soon we'll also be coming up with solutions towards flexible packaging. Now the second area that we were working on was the styrofoam and the single-use plastics. What happens is, especially in India, when hot food is served in a styrofoam plate, and a lot of it happens in the malls, the airlines, the airports, and various other places. So when you, no matter how with hygienic conditions you prepare your food, but as soon as it is served in a styrofoam plate, it leaks carcinogens in it and thus makes the food that we are consuming unsafe. And thus, when we were looking towards the solutions for that, that is when we found bagasse and we started producing compostable products out of that. Now in the morning, Mr. Shailesh was also talking about the circular economy. So for 37 years, we have been practicing it actually. So in our factory, none of the power that is generated is taken from the power plant, but we generate our own power using rice husk and biomass. So there are various ways through which you can completely relook at the manufacturing processes that you have and be a little more environment conscious and thus rethink of the process. So we are also, we also got B certified. So which is B Corp certification is a certification that really audits your entire system for 1 year and then certifies that you are an environmentally conscious company. So we are the only pulp to product company in the world. So what happens is globally, this entire value chain is divided into three steps. One is the pulp production, then the second one is the product making, and then third is the distribution and marketing. But we wanted to have all of that in-house, and thus we became the first integrated pulp to product company in which the farmers are growing sugarcane, which is getting then harvested and sent to sugar mills, and then we take the waste and make it into pulp, cook it, and then convert it into the final product, and then it is distributed. And after that, it's not only till the end consumption, then what happens to it after you have consumed the food? So because it is backyard compostable, so that is when you throw it to the ground, within 60 days it turns into soil and contributes to the Mother Earth. Now along with this, when we started working towards working on this, developing the solution for this compostable packaging, so research was a really, really important element, and that is when we partnered with our design partners, Therefore Design in Pune, and we undertook this research of 2 years in which we really understood how India eats. Now India, being a diverse country, has various methods of eating. So we eat with our hands, we eat with a spoon. So when we really looked at it, so we saw that these cups and plates and bowls were never really designed for the Indian market. It was actually designed for the Western market and then just blindly copied over here. So the fundamental difference that we saw was that in the West, the plating is done from center towards the sides. So your main piece of meat will be in the center and then salads and dressings will be on the side. So it's center to corners. Whereas in India, we have these, the plating is really done from the corners towards the inside. So that's why we need maximum surface area. So if you would see that all the katoris are towards the side and then your chapati or the rice is towards the corners as well. So that is when we saw this major difference, and thus we completely had a re-look at the shape and the design and the functionality of the entire product that we were making. Now again, another thing that we found out was that it was never designed as a family of products. So what was happening in the Indian scenario was there'll be a plate and the there'll be a tray, and the plate will come from somewhere else, the cup will come from somewhere else, and everything will be just aggregated on a tray and be given to the end customer. So it was never really designed for the Indian market and as a family of products. This also meant a huge inventory for the distributors, because each and every product was different, and so different inventory had to be maintained, and inventory management was a big issue. So we really looked at it as a system design completely, catering to the entire value chain that the product will be going through. And thus, we came up with this innovative design of modular compostable tableware, which was designed as a family of products in which the 180 bowl, the smallest bowl, was used as a building element, and we came up with a solution in which each and every product would fit into each other and was designed as a family of products. It has also won the Red Dot Award, the highest design award in the world, CII Design Excellence in India Mark. So as I said, modularity was one of the key features that we looked at, in which inspiration was taken from Lego. So how a small block can have different permutations and combinations, and you can build onto anything. So drawing from that concept, we made a modular compostable tableware in which one thing fits into another, and which really also decreases the inventory management, because everything fits into another and is designed as a family of products. So it really solves these issues as well. Now the design detailing. So not only that, but also, as I said, when we were studying the eating pattern of Indians, so the depth and the corners and the entire detailing of design was done in such a way that the spoon can really go inside the bowl without toppling the bowl, or your fingers can also enter and you can easily have the entire eating experience that you would want. So each and every depth, each and every dimension of the product was given that detail and catered to the Indian market and the way of eating. And again, even if we talk about costs, so it is because India is also a price sensitive market, so it was very, very important for us as well that the cost consideration is kept in mind. And that's why we had the fully automatic, the biggest machines in the world, and we came down to a production capacity which could enable us to get the price at a comparable level to plastic. Now, as I said, in this, form really followed the function. So it was really the functionality of the entire product that we were making that really drove the design decisions that we ultimately took. So it was a minimal material usage, which would just serve the purpose for which the product is being designed. So it was a minimum and clean design really that we went for. So it is a minimalist, modular, functionally optimum, and it is versatile as a range with the modularity concept. Now again, so the food, the tableware that we were currently using was being used to serve freshly prepared food, but now we are also venturing, as everyone's talking about, that the lifestyle is changing, the population is growing, and more number of people are working, so deliveries are on an increase. And thus, we are also launching a lid, which is this. So it is made out of a corrugated sheet, and it uses a ventlet patented technology, which lets the steam escape, yet the food inside remains warm. So the ultimate product that we got, it is completely safe to eat from because it is made out of compostable and natural material, which is sugarcane. It has no carcinogens because it is completely safe, no bleaching, and thus we stayed brown. And rigorous quality tests, so each and every batch is tested for oil and water testing. And obviously there is no harm. Now it is not one of the products in which you can eat the food and eat the bowl as well, as one of the products that you had mentioned. But if even if you consume it, it is not bad for you, but we would not recommend that. But it does no harm to the marine life or animals or nature in general. Now again, this is the view of the factory. As I said, that we are producing to really cause a dent in the growing pile of plastic. So we went with the biggest machineries, and we have a production capacity of 1 million pieces per day, which we want to double in 2019 and then going forward. So the video. What? Sorry?